Okay, on your slide, you're able to see the disadvantages of the hard water. As till now, you are aware about that hardness, that what is the hardness and how many type of the hardness are there in the water sample or in water resources. So now we can discuss the disadvantages of the hardness. As hard water contains large amount of the bicarbonate, sulfates, chlorides of heavy metals. And these heavy metals are majorly, we are actually concerning about that calcium and the magnesium salts. Although iron, aluminium, like heavy metals are also causing that hardness, okay, at a little extent. So it causes many number of the problems in the domestic uses as well as industrial use. And industrial use, where we are actually using the water in boilers for steam generation, okay. So first I'm going to discuss few domestic uses of water where we can face the disadvantages of the hard water. So in washing and bathing, we are having the use of soap. And if the water is hard there, then what will form? Instead of that lather formation, we'll get a sticky precipitation. And these sticky precipitates will adhere on that fabric cloth or in case of washing and on our body in case of the bathing. Okay, and what are these precipitations? If you are going to use hard water and you use that soap, instead of formation of the micelle, or you can say the lather formation, the mechanism will get altered and you will get sticky precipitations of heavy metal fatty acids. Is it so? That's why we will not get that lathers. Instead, we get these curdy precipitates. Okay, and drinking. That if you consume the hard water in a limited amount, then you cannot say that particular water is harmful for you, because calcium and the magnesium are essential element for our body. But yes, it may have some bad effect on our digestive system, because that presence of that heavy metals like calcium may have that formation of the calcium oxalates in our urinary tract. Then it can harm our digestive system. Okay. And now cooking, if you use that hard water for your cooking, definitely an extra amount of that fuel or time will be there, because as you know, that hardness is due to that particularly salts, and these salts are actually have a poor conductor of heats. So unnecessary, you will have to cook that food for extra time, and you have to give extra fuel as well. Okay, certain foods don't cook soft also, and also gives unpleasant taste to your food. So these are some domestic use where you use you actually use water in your daily routine life, and you can feel if you use the hard water, you can have these troubles in your domestic uses. Then I'm going to discuss that some industrial uses. So that if first we are going to the textile industry, how that hard water causes any disadvantages to the textile industry. So hard water causes much of the soap, as you know, because of that first the big amount of that soap will consume to prepare that precipitate, then only you can get that leather after that, after consuming that all amount. So to go as waste, because hard water cannot produce good quality of the leather. Moreover, the precipitates of the calcium and the magnesium salts adhere to the fabric and gives results to your fabric. Okay, so these fabrics, when dried later on, do not produce exact shades of the color, and hence the whole efficiency or that yield of that particular textile industry will get affected. Okay. Coming on that sugar industry, as you know, in sugar industry there is a need to prepare or to have the crystallization of the sugar. If you are having a hard water, because of the presence of the ions in that water, the crystallization process of the sugar may be affected. And instead of the process of the or you can say instead getting the crystal form of that sugar, you will find some powder or that sulfur kind of that formation of the sugar, and definitely that industry will get affected by the presence of that ions in the water. Dyeing industry. Again, dyeing in an industry involved or in the production of dyes. So if hard water is there, means dissolved kind of calcium, magnesium and iron salts are there in hard water. So it forms undesirable precipitates, which yields impure shades and gives spots on your fabric being dyed. Okay. So now if I'm going to discuss paper industry. So again, paper industry is having that particular formation, or it actually provides a smooth and the glossy finish to the paper. But if calcium magnesium salts are there, then they tend to react with the chemical and other materials, and they will not provide an that smooth net or glossy structure. Your paper will not be having finishing. Okay. So moreover, iron salts may affect the colors of the paper being produced in the industry. The pharmaceutical industry, as you know, in pharmaceutical industry, the drugs, injections, ointments, or are preparing that particular industry in the pharmaceutical side. So if you are having hardness or hardness causing ions in that, they may produce certain undesirable product in them. So, and they can be harmful for the mankind. And lastly, in the steam generation in boiler, this is the actually I highlighted it by the red color because this is the point where in industry, everywhere, every industry is used somewhere that boiler for steam generation for the heat. So I'm going to discuss this particular use in detail. So first one, the boiler troubles due to hard water. After that, if your water is hard and you feed it that water, hard water, to the boiler, what troubles that boiler may face? So boiler feed water before, or you can say the water before feeding into the boiler must correspond to the, some compositions, and these compositions are there on your screen. Its hardness should be below 0.2 ppm.
Ma'am.
Yes, beta.
Have you changed the slide?
Yes.
Ma'am, on my screen, it is freezed. I think the others are also facing the same.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, on your slide, what you are able to see?
Ma'am, the heading is disadvantage of water still.
Okay, now?
Yet same.
So yes, let me first stop sharing. Yes. Again, share it. Is it visible now on your screen? It is written boiler troubles due to hard water.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now is it moving?
No. Freezed again, I think.
It's freezed.
Yes, ma'am. Again, it's still the boiler troubles due to hard water. See, now it is changed back. Now again, forward. One is sludge.
Okay. Okay, now it's fine. Okay. So on your screen, you are able to see some compositions of the water. Before feeding that water into the boiler, you must complete the particular compositions of the water. Okay. So its hardness should be below 0.2 ppm. Its caustic alkalinity should be in the range of 0.15 to 0.45. Its soda alkalinity should be in the range of 0.45 to 1 ppm. Okay, but if your water is not having that composition, or somehow your water is having impurities, or that impurity is present in the water, and you feed that water into the boiler, so at the that working condition, or you can say at high temperature and pressure, definitely it will be there in the boiler at working condition, because the steam will be going to generate at that particular condition only. So the boiler may face these certain kinds of the formations. Or the boiler may face these certain kinds of the troubles. And which are they? They are the first ones, scale and sludge formation, may be there because of the presence of these impurities in the water. Boiler corrosion, your boiler material can be, get corrosion. Third one, caustic embrittlement, because of the presence of some caustic substances, that particular material of the boiler may get brittle. Or last one is the priming and forming. So if certain kind of the impurities are there, so these particular formations or may also take place. So these are very important for the, if I'm talking for that prospect of quizzes, viva, and your examinations. Okay. So one by one, I'm going to discuss all these problems. First one, sludge. What is the sludge formation inside?
Ma'am, these three composition are necessary or these can be maximum?
No. These are actually mandatory for the boiler.
Okay.
So these are from that some, I pick these standards from some industrial standards. Okay, you can get these information in your books or in Indian standard as well. Okay, then sludge, first formation of the sludge, I'm going to discuss in detail. What is the sludge? Sludge
again,
is
the
a
slide is freezed.
Now you are on your screen. What's there?
Boiler,
are you not able to
see bubbles that? Due to hard water.
So everybody is facing the same thing?
Yes, ma'am.
You are still on the boiler troubles.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Hard water. Okay, now. Okay, now I've shared it again.
Not yet visible.
No. Yes, ma'am.
How?
Yeah.
Actually, I think the last screen is not working today. Maybe some network error is there. So, okay. We'll go like this only. So you are able to see the screen now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I think that slideshow is not having function today because of some error. So first one, I'm going to discuss the sludge formation. What is the sludge? Sludge is a soft, loose, slimy precipitate formed inside the boiler. If your water is having certain kind of the substances as impurities like magnesium carbonate, magnesium chloride, calcium chloride, and magnesium sulfate, all these are having their tendency, they are having the greater solubility in the hot water, hot regions of the boiler, or you can say hot water, but they get precipitated out in colder portions of the boiler. So they collect in the area of the systems where these colder portions are there, or you can say at the area of the bands, and where the flow rate of the water is low. So that's the reason for the formation of these slimy precipitates. So with the help of a boiler transection, I'm able to show you that formation. So that particular brown, this is actually a boiler. That brown outer layer is the boiler wall. In that boiler, water is fed, and in at high temperature, or you can say working condition of the boiler, if this certain kind of the impurities are there, which are having its tendency to make a loose precipitates, so you may face the formation of sludge and the slimy loose precipitates called sludge suspended in the water. You can see in the picture as well. Okay, as these are very slimy and the loose precipitates, so they are very easy to remove. To remove these sludges, precipitates are easy by applying any boom operation or simply by filtration. Of that water after that time. Okay, now disadvantages of the sludge formation, as these precipitates are poor conductor of heat, So definitely the whole working of the boiler disturbed, and if along with the scale both get deposited at the scale, so the sludge formation is actually having trouble for the boiler. Now how to prevent? I already explained, by applying the blowdown operations or by simply feeding the your boiler by soft water. Now the scale formation. What is the scale formation in the boiler? Formation are the hard substances which sticks very long to the inner surface of the boiler bowl. The formation of this hard stick layer in the boiler bowl is very difficult to remove even with the help of some.
Ma'am, your voice is breaking a bit.
Yes, beta. Discussing the scale formation. So, what is the scale formation? Scale actually due to the presence of some kind of that salts like calcium sulfate, calcium carbonate, magnesium hydroxide. Yes. There is something. Okay, but what is the scale formation? Scale are actually the hard substance which sticks very firm the inner surface of the boiler because of the presence of certain kind of the impurities. They are highlighted in the red color on your screen. They have their tendency to get adhered inside that inner wall of the.
Ma'am, your voice is cracking a lot.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Let me change some setting. Okay, now am I audible?
Yes. Am I audible now? I got disconnected. Yes, ma'am. Audio, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I was explaining that scale formation. So what is the scale formation? Due to the presence of some impurities like calcium sulfate, calcium carbonate and magnesium hydroxide type of that salts, at working condition that boiler may face scale formation, and that is the hard adherent coating on inner wall of the boiler. You can see that particular layer in that boiler section where again the brown color is the boiler wall and the water is fed inside it. So that hard adherent coating on the inner wall of the surface is actually the scale formation. And it is very difficult to remove this layer even with any sharp object because it is a very firm and the hard coating or the layer. So with the help of a mechanism, I also explained that the chemistry of behind that scale formation. So at high pH, the carbonate and the bicarbonates are there. Even you know that chemistry of the different ions in your alkalinity experiment also, you can check that your fact the same here. The pH at higher pH, all the carbonates and all the are there. And they actually react with the calcium type of that ions and may form the calcium carbonate at that temperature. And you know that calcium carbonate is most insoluble type of that salt. So it may form that scale, or that is the reason for the scale formation. Okay. So, what are the different reasons for formation of the scale? As the scale is the biggest trouble that boiler may face. So if your water is contaminated by the presence of calcium bicarbonate, so in low pressure boilers, you may face the scale formation because of the presence of that calcium bicarbonate. So what will the chemistry behind it? The calcium carbonate at high temperature in the low pressure boiler form the calcium carbonate and water and the carbon dioxide. Water will not having any trouble. What about that calcium carbonate? So it is actually the reason for the scale formation. And what about carbon dioxide? Yes, it is a gas. It is a dissolved kind of carbon dioxide inside the water. It may also form harm that boiler in other way. We will discuss this in later sections of the troubles. So second one, presence of calcium sulfate in the water. If calcium sulfate type of the impurities are there in the water and you feed it that water in the boiler, so calcium sulfate is having its tendency. It is having greater solubility. Yes.
Yeah.
Calcium sulfate is having its tendency. It is of the calcium sulfate in water. During the class, try to mute yourself, beta. Otherwise, I have to go on that page and I have to mute all. So, what we were discussing presence of calcium sulfate. So, calcium sulfate is having that tendency, or it is the chemistry of that calcium sulfate is it is soluble in cold water, but its solubility is actually decreased with rise of the temperature. And the solubility of that calcium sulfate at different temperatures. I also mentioned these different values in a table on your screen. So at 15 degrees Celsius, the solubility of the calcium sulfate is 3200 ppm. But as the temperature is actually increases, so with the increase of the temperature, the solubility of that particular salt is get decreased. So you can say that in cold water, the calcium sulfate is soluble. But at superheated water, it actually becomes insoluble. Or you can say that is the reason for the formation of the scale inside the boiler, in high pressure boiler. Okay, so it is very important question One may ask you this particular chemistry or that reason of the scale in your quizzes or in any way of your examination. Then presence of magnesium chloride in high at high temperature in the boiler may also form scale. Like magnesium chloride is having its reaction, it will get react the water in high temperature and form magnesium hydroxide and HCl. That magnesium hydroxide, you already aware that it is the reason for the scale formation. It is having its tendency to form a hard coating inside that layer or the boiler. And HCl is also actually causing trouble to the boiler. We will also discuss this in later troubles. Then presence of the silica, it actually forms insoluble hard adherent calcium silicate and magnesium silicate. And it is very hard to remove if once that silicates are formed inside the boiler's wall. So they will actually get accumulated there in the form of a layer. So now the disadvantages of the scale formation, again, that as these salts are very, or these precipitates or the layers are a poor conductor, so wastage of the fuel will be there, lowering boiler's safety by degrading the boiler's material and decrease the efficiency. Definitely the whole efficiency of the boiler get affected by that presence of that ions. Then if cracks occurs in that scale layer, so danger of that explosion may take place. Or you can say that these are the different disadvantages of the scale formation. So how to remove these scale formation inside the boiler? So by thermal shocking, heating and cooling suddenly with the water, one is the method sometimes applied for that removal of that scale. And also for by using chemicals like 5 to 10% of the HCl, or by adding some complex like EDTA, you are able to remove that scale. So now coming on that another trouble the boiler may face if you feed it that boiler with the hard water or some impure water. So second one is the boiler corrosion. As you already aware about that, I think you already aware about that corrosion. You must study that part in your earlier classes as well. So degradation or destruction of the boiler material due to chemical and the electrochemical attack of dissolved gases or the salt is called boiler corrosion. One by one, I'm picking that the different kinds of the presence of these materials, how these particular gases or the salts are get affected or give corrosion to the boiler material. So first one is corrosion due to dissolved oxygen. So corrosion due to dissolved oxygen, if water is having that dissolved oxygen and you feed it that water in the boiler, then you know the boiler material is majorly is using iron. So iron is having again reaction with the dissolved oxygen and forms ferrous hydroxide, and that ferrous hydroxide eventually form ferric oxide hydrate, and that ferric hydroxide hydrate is actually the corrosion caused to the iron is rust. Okay, so to remove that dissolved oxygen in the water, we have to use some reducing agents kinds of that chemicals. And these are like hydrazine, sodium sulfite, and sodium sulfide. So by using these chemicals, we can able to remove the dissolved oxygen. They are having that reaction with the oxygen and form less toxic or non-toxic substances. So in case of the hydrazine, nitrogen and the water will be on the right hand side, and they will not cause any type of the trouble to the boiler anymore. Now sodium sulfide will react having the reaction with the dissolved oxygen and will convert that oxygen into sodium sulfate. And you know that sodium sulfate is a dissolved kind of that salt, and it will not cause any type of that trouble to your boiler at that high condition of temperature and the pressure. And so with the sodium sulfide. And now the corrosion due to dissolved carbon dioxide. If your water is having dissolved carbon dioxide, where you find that carbon dioxide is evolved in the process, if your water is having the presence of bicarbonate salts of either magnesium or calcium, that at high temperature and pressure, you will get magnesium carbonate and it will actually cause the scale, and then H2O and carbon dioxide. And that carbon dioxide is actually in the dissolved state and it is having a tendency to cause a slow corrosion to the boiler material. Then the corrosion due to dissolved salts, if magnesium chloride type of the dissolved salts or the dissolved impurities are there in the water, and you know that magnesium chloride is also is one of the cause for the temporary hardness. Am I correct? Temporary hardness, magnesium chloride?
Yes, ma'am.
Magnesium chloride is causing temporary hardness in water.
No.
Permanent
hardness. Okay, magnesium chloride is causing permanent hardness because it is not easy to remove magnesium chloride by simply boiling. So if these type of the salts are there in the water and you feed it that water into the boiler, they may react with the water and form magnesium hydroxide, or you can say the corresponding hydroxide, and HCl. So magnesium hydroxide definitely will cause scale. But what about the HCl, which is actually released in that particular reaction? That HCl may react with the boiler's material, and that is iron, and will form ferric chloride. And that ferric chloride may react with the water to form ferrous hydroxide, and that ferrous hydroxide, if dissolved kind of the oxygen will be there, definitely can corrode that boiler's material and will form ferric oxide hydrate. Got it? So these are all that chemistry behind that boiler's corrosion, how that particular corrosion may take place there if certain kind of the impurities are there in your water and you feed that water into the boiler. Those are certain conditions of high temperature and the pressure. These steps may be there. Okay, so boiler corrosion by acid formation can be prevented by adding calculated amount of alkali, because acid is there. If acid release there in somehow in the boiler, so by simply adding calculated amount of the alkali, you may neutralize that acid, and thus the further steps will not be formed, or you can be able to resolve that corrosion problem by adding that calculated amount of the alkali by keeping the pH value between 8 to 9. And why that particular pH have to be there, or you that concern? Because if you added that alkali in excess, so they may cause caustic embrittlement to your boiler. This is actually the third trouble, or I'm going to discuss the boiler's trouble, third one, the caustic embrittlement. As the name itself suggesting, somehow your material of that boiler becomes brittle. So what's the actually reason behind that brittleness? To accumulate of excess alkali in the boiler. Accumulation of excess alkali in the boiler is actually the cause for boiler's materials to become brittle. It is a form of the stress corrosion, particularly at those places which are under stress, such as bands and the joints. Okay, with the result that metal plates become brittle and that boiler is actually weakened by deposition of this, or you can say the brittle, and that boiler may get explosion, danger of explosion. So what is the chemistry behind it? Sodium carbonate is having this reaction with the H2O and form NaOH plus CO, carbon dioxide. So how to prevent that formation of the embrittlement or that accumulation? So simply applying some compounds or adding some compounds like tannin and lignin, sodium sulfate and NaOH in ratios, depending on the working of the boiler. Boiler is having the different working pressures. So depending on that, we actually choose a different type of that compounds, and how they will be able to prevent that casting embrittlement or that accumulation by blocking the minute cracks. And hence they prevent the infiltration of the alkali. So that alkali will not be able to accumulate in certain areas or that stress areas of that boiler. Okay, so now priming and forming. So first one, the primer is priming. If your water is actually contaminated by some impurities or some ions or the particles, So at high temperature pressure, if that process in which some particles in the water are carried along with the steam. So at that pressure or that temperature, the steam is actually evaporating, or the steam in that case, some particles in the water also carried along with the steam. And sometimes that particle is having that much of the force, that much of the pressure, they may actually explode that boiler material as well. So this resulting process, or this whole process, is known as the priming, or during this process that carried particles with the steam is known as wet steam or carry over. I'm also showing you with the help of a figure on your screen. You are able to see that normal, how that normal bubble is formed inside the boiler, and what is the carryover bubble, or you can say the wet steam. Okay, so the process of formation of the wet steam in a boiler is called as priming. If some certain kind of the impurities or the particles are there in the water, so they may also carry along with the steam and with the pressure. Okay, then foaming, it is the process, this is the production of that continuous foam or the hard bubble in the boiler. And what is the cause to form that foam inside that boiler? If your water is having presence of certain kind of the oils or alkalis, then the water may form a continuous foam or the hard bubble layer on upper layer of the water. Now again, if pressure built up inside that water due to the high pressure or temperature, so again it may get the danger of the explosion due to the formation of that foaming. So how to prevent the priming and the foamings? There are certain methods. They are there on your screen. You can read these by your own. I will post this presentation to your channel. Okay, so these are very theoretical ones, so you can read these by your own. So now, preventions of scale formation. As that scale formation is actually very troublesome to your boiler, so how, before feeding that water, how to resolve that hardness, or how to soften your water? There are certain treatments for that. So these are the preventions of the scale formation. So first one is the external treatment, and the second one is the internal treatments. So before feeding the water inside the boiler, the treatments which may help to resolve that hardness or to soften your water, they are the external ones, or you can say the preventive methods. In your case, we will study the three: zeolite process, lime soda process, and the ion exchange process. We will discuss all these treatments one by one in detail in next class. And if somehow we are not able to resolve that particular hardness externally, so there are certain treatments also, or you can say that corrective methods. So once we feed it that water inside the boiler, we can also resolve that hardness, or we can soften our water by applying these internal treatments inside the boiler. So these are colloidal carbonate phosphate calgon conditioning. So by applying these treatments, by using these methods, we can condition our water inside the boiler. Okay, so let me discuss these particular internal conditioning treatments. First one, the phosphate conditioning. Actually, all the conditioning methods are involved some kind of that salts or chemicals. By applying these, we are able to resolve that salts, or we are actually converting that hardness causing salts in non hardness, or you can say we are actually converting that salts in some other compounds or the salts by applying these chemicals or the compounds. So first one is the phosphate conditioning. By addition of simple some phosphate compounds, we are going to condition our water, which is there fed inside the boiler. And we are able to remove, or you can say we are able to remove the hardness causing salts, or soften our water by applying that phosphate compound. carbonate conditioning by applying some carbonate compounds, we are able to remove that particular hardness. By Calgon conditioning means by using Calgon. Calgon is a trade name for sodium hexametaphosphate. So by addition of the sodium hexametaphosphate, we will condition our water. Colloidal conditioning by spreading the organic compounds like tannin and agar gel, and they will form the colloid. And now you can feel your water is no more hard. The first one, phosphate conditioning. So scale formation can be prevented by adding sodium phosphate to the boiler water, which reacts with the hardness producing iron and forms a easily removable phosphate salts of respective iron. So this is the chemistry behind that particular phosphate conditioning. If your water is having calcium chloride type of the impurity, or you can say calcium chloride is which type of the hardness this calcium chloride cause to your water? Permanent. Okay, then that calcium chloride react with sodium phosphate and will convert that calcium chloride into a precipitate, or you can say the calcium phosphate. Now this calcium phosphate salt can easily remove by applying some filtration or blow down operations. And the second one is a sodium chloride. This will not cause any hardness. This will not cause any trouble to your boiler. Got it? Second one, carbonate conditioning. In low pressure boiler, the scale formation can be avoided by adding sodium carbonate to the boiler water. So if I'm saying calcium sulfate type of the impurity will be there and you are going to add sodium carbonate. So as a result, you will get calcium carbonate and sodium sulfate. And calcium carbonate, you know, this is the most insoluble salt. You will be able to remove that by blow down operations, because in that step, you will found the precipitates are in the form of loose sludge of calcium carbonate. And sodium sulfate, again, it will not cause any type of that hardness, as sodium is a light element. It is not a heavy element. Now, Calgon conditioning. By simply applying Calgon or adding Calgon in your boiler, you will be able to resolve that impurity by converting it into a highly soluble complex. So you can see that presence of calcium sulfate inside the boiler water. And if you are using sodium hexametaphosphate, there is an iron dissociation take place in that Calgon, where you get that anion, and that anion is actually going to react with that calcium present in that particular calcium sulfate and will react or form a complex, or so you can say soluble complex ion of the calcium, and it will not cause any trouble to your boiler as well with that sodium sulfate. Again, it is not causing any type of the hardness. Then colloidal conditioning in low pressure boiler scale. Formation is there, then you have to add some organic substances like kerosene, agar agar and tannin. And you will get a non-sticky loose precipitates will be there, and you can easily remove these colloidals or that formation of the precipitates by any blow down operation or by simply filtration. Got it? I think that much is sufficient for today's lecture. We will discuss the external treatments in our next class. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. These things or these terms or these conditionings or treatments or troubles, they are very easy to understand. The thing is, you have to read, you have to give time to read these all terms and the chemistry behind these particular terms or conditioning and troubles. Is it so? SIE? So in today's lecture, we covered first disadvantages of hard water. Then we discussed some problems that boiler may face if we feed it that water, a boiler with hard water. Then reasons behind the scale formation, and then internal treatment to prevent scale formation. Okay, I think that much is sufficient for today's lecture. The thing is, logo ko इस सबको रीड करना है. इफ एनीबडी इज हैविंग एनी डाउट और एनी क्वेरी आप पूछ सकते हैं.
मैम
यस बेटा.
मैम आई हैव अ डाउट दिस प्राइमिंग दैट यू टॉट कुड यू एक्सप्लेन इट लाइक अगेन हाउ इज इट अ डिसएडवांटेज.
प्राइमिंग
यस मैम प्राइमिंग.
So are you able to see this priming on the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
So you know when boiler is steaming means producing the steam rapidly, some particles of the liquid water are carried along with the steam. The process of this particles carried away along with the steam is known as wet steam formation. This is actually called priming. And priming is caused by the presence of large amount of dissolved solids or impurities. Sometimes boilers design also, improper boilers design also cause that priming. As a result, a sudden steam production will be there, and it may have the danger of the explosion as well. It's very simple to understand what's in it. It is a process in which some particles are actually carried along with that water, along that steam, at that steam production time, or you can say when that boiler is steaming rapidly, some particles of the liquid water are carried along with the steam. Sometimes if that particular steam is contaminated with some type of the impurities, that may cause certain high pressure and explosion may take place. So what is in it? Aapko kya samajh nahi aaya isme?
Oh ma'am, like I did not understand, like how will the steam cause any disadvantage? Now I understood that if the process is rapid, then there could be a chance of explosion.
The steaming is always a rapid process, na? On certain impurities are there, which actually hinders heat to dissipate. So definitely, that time that pressure may build up. Sudden increase in the steam production rate is actually causing that priming, which actually causes a large amount of, or you can say, danger of explosion. So with the case of the foaming as well, if oils and alkali are there as impurity, they may produce or they may form a hard bubble layer on the upper side of that water. It is the production of the persistent foam and the bubbles in the boiler, which do not break easily.
Okay, ma'am.
So anyone else? So I think now I can conclude the lecture. Definitely at 11 you will be having your another lecture. First I am downloading the attendance.